Hi, my name's Larry DiMarzio, and this is my 1960 Stratocaster. I wanted to do this video because it's not often that you'd get a chance to see a guitar in this condition and of this quality. It's got a mint green pickguard and a three-color sunburst. The body's older, and the guitar, like all Stratocasters, has one volume and two tone controls. In 1959, Fender introduced the Rosewood Stratocaster. It's a slab rosewood fingerboard and differs from the guitars that came later. Slab rosewood strats have special meaning to me because it was my first solid body guitar. In the late 60s, I bought one while I was at university, and it was a disaster. Everything needed to be repaired. It's how I learned to repair guitars. And when I found this one, I had to keep it. So it's been in my collection since the early 70s. Somewhere a king has no wife, and the wind it cries very. The frets are original. The body cuts were more dramatic, and the 60 Strat still has the more dynamic cuts. I've always preferred these to the more rounded over versions. The selector switch was designed to give you neck, middle, or bridge pickup. It became common practice for guitar players to use it in the in-between positions, giving you that classic Hendrix sound, or later that Eric Clapton sound. Looking underneath, you see an aluminum shielding plate. This was done to help reduce noise. My 60 Strat was never rewired, and I decided to keep it completely original. Be sure to press the View Specs button at the bottom of the page to get extra info about the guitar and other features about the pickups. This pickup has enamel wire. Looking at the bottom, here is why they're called slab rosewoods. The later models were done with a veneer, and this was done with a thicker piece of rosewood. 960. Wow. Normally, there would be a date written in the heel. However, since this one is painted black, it can't be seen. The bridges are amazing. They offered independent string adjustment, both height and intonation, as well as a tremolo or vibrato effect. The spring tension could be adjusted in the back, although I always preferred 5 springs, and I like to keep it tight. It seemed to stay in tune longer. All early Fenders have 2-piece bridges. The top portion is made from hardened steel, and the bottom portion is made from a different metal that was machined. The combination of this bridge also gives it its unique sound. Thanks for watching my video. I hope you enjoyed it. When I'm standing